Hi! While I'm working on the droid colony building project, I decided to take a little break and take part in Ludum Dare 51. In case you don't know, it's a game jam where you have just a couple of days to make a game on a particular theme. I've chosen the Ludum Dare Compo format, where you have just 2 days and you're not allowed to use any pre-existing art, textures, models, music, sound effects and so on. You can, however, use a game engine or any pre-existing code, so it's not that bad. It's the 11th time I'm participating in a game jam, so I felt pretty confident about it. I usually prepare for the jam by sketching a few game ideas beforehand. This time I came up with three options: a generic racing game, a medieval or modern town simulator where you move around, interact with NPCs and do some stuff, and a physics-based space shooter with a modular starship. The theme, which is announced at the beginning of the jam, turned out to be every 10 seconds. I decided to stick with the racing game idea because I figured a nice and simple way to incorporate the theme into it. Every 10 seconds, the track you're driving on gets replaced with a new one. With this idea in mind, I immediately jumped into prototyping. I do have some experience with physical simulations. In fact, I made a whole Twitter thread on implementing a basic physics engine, which I'll link in the description. But I've never actually worked on any vehicles. And car physics is pretty involved. A car is easy to move forward and much harder to move sideways. Everything depends on the orientation of the wheels and so on. Thankfully, I don't need a complex realistic car physics simulation for a game made in just 2 days, so I simply put together something that looks alright. One thing I noticed from the start is that if you rotate the car to the right when pressing the right button, then backward movement feels wrong, the car is actually turning left. So I'm flipping the turning direction in this case. Next, I moved on to work on the tracks. Since the tracks will be changing every 10 seconds, I need loads of them, and it seemed natural to generate them procedurally. My idea was to generate a center line of the track as a sequence of cubic hermit splines, and then build the actual track around it. Hermit splines are really nice for this because they allow me to specify a set of points the track should go through and the derivative of the track at each point, which controls the orientation and curvature of the track. For generating the control points, I put a bunch of points uniformly on a circle, assign the tangent vectors as the corresponding derivatives, and apply random offsets and rotations. This way the generated track always ends up being a nice closed loop. Now that I think of it, it wasn't actually necessary since the track will be replaced in just 10 seconds, and maybe using a different algorithm would produce more interesting results. I visualized the generated center line and tried to drive the car along it. Then I generated the actual track mesh from the center line. I sampled each spline segment in regular intervals and added points on the sides of the track. This is how the resulting tracks looked like. I was more or less satisfied with it, but it was clear that car physics needed some adjustments to make driving feel better. Next, I added a simple noise texture with basic road markings to make it look more like an actual road. Then I made a pretty simple racing car model. This is how it looks in-game. I also tweaked the controls a bit and made it impossible to rotate the car if it isn't moving. Next, I added wheels as a separate model and made them rotate when the car moves or turns. I also made the camera angle react to car acceleration. Honestly, this prototype is already somewhat fun at this point. It was about the time to add some AI opponents that would compete with the player. I added a bunch of cars with different colors and implemented some hacky collisions. They're far from perfect, but they look reasonable and I'm quite happy with them. At this point I realized that you shouldn't actually be able to cross the track border, so I added a simple tire fence and implemented collisions with it as well. The tracks are quite large and iterating over each border segment to detect collisions is really bad for performance reasons, so I used spatial hashing to speed things up. Basically I have a square grid of tiles and every border segment is stored in all tiles that it intersects, then I only need to check collisions in the tiles that intersect the car. I was going to finally start working on the AI, but I suddenly had a fun idea. It would be cool to have tracks that are visually distinct from each other. So I added a desert track type with different colors, road texture and border. I also added a simple distance fog effect to help with the track's atmosphere. Then I decided to implement the Bane twist of the game, switching the track every 10 seconds. It works like this. I compute each car's relative position on the track, and then place the car at the same relative position on the new track, where relative position is basically the percentage of the track that is behind the car. For example, a relative position of 50% means the car has completed exactly half of the track. This way I can guarantee that the player is always doing some progress on the track, even if the new track has a different length. I tried a number of different track switching effects and settled on this one. Then I finally implemented some basic AI to the player's opponents. I wanted the AI to be as simple as possible and also avoid doing any long-term planning because of the track switching, so I tried to figure out an approach based exclusively on the local track parameters. After trying a ton of different options, I settled on the following. The AI always tries to turn the car in the direction of the track's curvature and accelerates if it is sufficiently lined up with the track. I'm using the track's centerline second derivative as an approximation to curvature, since I can compute it exactly from the Hermite splines. The whole AI takes about a dozen lines of code. It's not the smartest, but it more or less follows the track and this is enough. Then I added this little line that shows each car's position along the track, added some useful information on the screen and the starting timer, implemented counting how many laps a car has made, and finally added a victory screen. This is where the first day of development ended, and I have to say I was pretty satisfied with the result. It's already a playable and somewhat enjoyable game. The first thing I realized on the next day is that the tracks look a bit dull, and it just feels weird to drive in the void. So I added simple ground textures and some environment objects like trees, bushes, stones, and cacti. Then I realized that even a tiny game like this one needs a main menu. After all, it's pretty confusing to launch a game and get immediately thrown into a race. Then I added a new track type, filled with snow and cool icy spikes. I also added a speedometer in the bottom of the screen. In retrospect, I can say that this was a pretty bad location for it, because the player's vision is mostly concentrated in the upper part of the screen, where the track is. Next, I decided it was the time to add some sounds to the game. I do have some basic audio support in my engine, though it is quite primitive and buggy. I used this online tool to generate sound effects and made a button sound, a countdown sound, a collision sound, and some really derpy car engine sounds. I tried my best to make them sound at least okay, but given my limited experience and time, this is what I ended up with. So, in order to soften the sounds, I also added some background music generated by this awesome online tool. The sounds are still there, but the fact that they're terrible is a bit smoothed by the music. I actually completely redesigned the audio subsystem in my engine after the gem, and wrote a blog article about it. I'll leave a link to it in the video description. I figured I still had some time left, so I added yet another track type, which looks kind of like a swamp. And that's it, the game's finished. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out, given that I made it in just 2 days. The track switching idea was definitely a good one. It allows the player to take advantage in some situations, and adds a unique touch to the overall game feel. Some parts of the game could definitely be improved, given more time. I'd be really happy if you tried the game, and of course, feel free to provide any feedback. By the way, the source code for the game is completely open. I'll leave all the links in the description. Thanks for watching and see you! You.
Thank you.